All right, so it's a new year, and I'm gonna show you my strategy for planning the next 5 to make sure that your best vision and your best reality occurs. I'm Scott Oldford. Let's make some shit happen. So a lot of the time people get obsessed with goals. I don't actually like goals at all, actually. I think goals actually limit us because we can only create what we can see. And if I look back at my life almost every single year, I don't know, crazy shit happens. Maybe the same thing's for you. Or maybe it's the fact that we actually have to allow for crazy shit to happen inside of our life. Who knows? But what I do know is that ever since I adopted a couple of different strategies inside of my life, everything changed. And after being like super broke and super in debt to how life is now, it's a heck of a lot prettier than it is now than it was back then. I figured I'd share this with you. Here it is. So a lot of the time we look at the next year. So what I think we should instead look at is the first year, third year, and fifth year. So I would rather you take post-it notes. I took this from a good friend of mine, Alan. He actually owns Best Self Co. Really, really cool company. You should check it out. And we were at a mastermind and we basically created the next 5 years. So we put on post-it notes as much as you could go, all the things you wanted. All the things you wanted in the next year, all the things you wanted in the next 3 years, all the things you wanted in the next 5 years. And let your mind just go crazy, whatever it is. So I start writing down and all these different kind of crazy, interesting things. And I looked at that almost every single week. Had it up on my wall. It was there, very intentional about the things that I actually wanted. And it's crazy. I had 24 things for the last year and I got 23 of them. And the last one I actually decided to push forward. So you put them up on the wall and you put them in between, 0 to 1, 1 to 3, 3 to 5. And the interesting thing is that you start being like, shit, maybe I can do this faster. Maybe I can do this sooner. Maybe the crazy stuff that is there, maybe me admitting to myself that I want that was actually the key all along. And a lot of the time goals are about revenue or goals about this or goals about this. And instead of doing that, perhaps we should just focus on what we actually want in our life and then create the situation to be able to do that. Whether it's wanting a penthouse or a nice car or being able to buy an orphanage in Zimbabwe, it really doesn't matter. Once you know it, once you embody the fact that you actually want it and that you actually deserve it, you can go out and create it. So that was a really interesting exercise at the beginning of 2017. Now the next interesting thing that I started doing was, and I took this from another one of my friends, Mikkel, and he had a mentor. And so a lot of the time we don't actually plan for our fulfillment inside of our life. So there's 4 things that fulfill me: freedom, evolution, innovation, and creation. And I always think there's 4 things that fulfills anybody. And, it might be family, it might be, could be video games, could be creation, it could be photography, whatever it may be. And what I started doing is every single week, I started looking at what I wanted to accomplish that week and putting it into the 4 categories. So freedom, evolution, creation, and innovation. And what it started happening is I started creating weeks that started adding up, and I was doing things that I actually fully enjoyed, that I actually were fulfilled upon in. And so I started looking at this board and looking at the things I wanted to do and looking at the things that I actually enjoyed. And so when it comes to evolution, I wanted to evolve more. So I started surrounding myself with more entrepreneurs. I started doing more masterminds, not because I cared about the money, okay? I started innovating, so I started creating more content so I could create and see what worked and what didn't. See, I stopped looking for the money and I started looking for the fulfillment. I start doing the things that I actually enjoy. I started having the freedom and just kind of accepting the fact that I could live anywhere in the world, like most of us can, we just don't believe it. And I started being in locations that inspire me and allow me to go into flow and allow me to switch off my frontal cortex and go into points and moments in time in which I can speak, in which I can actually embody the ability to see where I want to go and what I want to do. And so these two pieces added together allowed me to live every single week into the future, but into the now. I was able to live in the present, but also see the future of what I wanted to create. So I utilized the power of now and the power of the future, combining those and allowing me to accomplish what I want to accomplish without making it about the goal or making it about the money. Because when we make it about the money, almost everything fails. But when we will make it about what fulfills us and what excites us, we're willing to go to the ends of the world for that. So, Scott Oldford here. And perhaps you may want to rethink the way that you set and achieve the goals in your life. So if you enjoyed this content and you want more of it, make sure you go ahead and subscribe. And if you want other entrepreneurs just like you to be able to also access this information, this knowledge, make sure you go ahead and share it with someone that means the most to you. Remember, as entrepreneurs, it's our job to be able to help other entrepreneurs continue to elevate, allowing us to evolve society and evolve our world. I'll see you next time. Bye.